become aware of the breath. When the breath moves into your belly, the belly button rises. When breath moves out, the belly button goes back. Become aware of the belly button, the movement of belly button, inwards and outwards. Become aware of the belly button movement, in and out. I am aware of the breath, but breath is not aware of me. I am consciousness. Gently become aware of self, the knowing principle which is aware of that. The breath is not aware of me. I am aware of breath. Become aware of the self who is watching the breath. If any thought comes, again take your attention to belly button, then gradually shift your attention to the awareness which is watching the belly button. The breath is movement in consciousness. I am consciousness, awareness. I am visible. I am invisible. The breath is visible. I can feel the breath, but I am the awareness watching the movement of breath. Take your attention to the I am, the awareness. Asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shanti
om shanti shanti shanti
lokah samasta
lokah
सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ happens in meditation teachings or meditation practice is people tell you watch the breath and ignore the thoughts. That is not meditation. Watch the breath to bring your mind to the present moment. The mind has to become present moment because by watching the breath. Present moment is gateway to the presence. So from present moment go back to the presence, which is I. Now the breath obsession goes down. So shift your attention from the object to the subject is called meditation. If you don't understand this, you will forever, millions of years, you keep on watching your breath. Watch the breath to enter into the present moment. From present moment, you enter into the presence, which is I am, consciousness. So that is called meditation.
Meditation. You speak about my experience in meditation. Present moment, sometimes you are like, I have the 45 minutes of mala. The breath is extremely subdued and not noticeable. But there is some expansion happening. Body consciousness has become low. So then, you are like some kind of a suspended.
Now that's where, what you are actually, from that also you have to further move on. So that's where, see the whole key of meditation is from the object to the subject you have to move. Even the expansion happening is an object. One who is aware of that is subject. Even that experience of expansion is an object. We'll get into that as we go to further lecture. Okay? So can we continue? So now, these two are different paths, okay? Path of progressive path and direct path. See, the progressive path, you are praying to an almighty infinite being to help you. In the direct path, you are going to that infinite being directly. So, it so happened that God created the universe. Okay? In his creativity, he created so many beautiful things. Plants, animals, everything. Then he created the human being and thought that, I have done the peak of, my creativity is broom. So man was created. Now he felt lonely. Then God thought, okay, this is a defective product, let me improve on that. And he created human. Woman, very beautiful, okay, lovely. Then the trouble started. So every day there's a demand. The wife tells the husband tells the God, this is missing, this is missing, this is missing. Okay. So then complaints are going every day. Then God asks for a cabinet meeting, comes for a cabinet meeting. The cabinet ministers also, what is that, sun, moon and all those cabinet meetings advise. It's a very dangerous place, okay, you have to escape from the human beings. So then said, you go under the sea. That's why Narayana is shown in the middle of the sea, escaping from everybody. Okay, but human beings are very smart. They created submarine. Okay, then he escaped the moon. In last century, they sent a rocket to moon also. No place. Then God said, I'll hide in the heart. So, the direct path people don't leave it there also. You have to go to the heart, they'll teach. So, this is how you go to the heart. So, now I don't know where God is going away, but maybe we'll find out. So, the difference between the direct path and progressive path, you have to understand. Okay? So, let me ask you the question. This universe, infinite universe, so vast, and that universe is called Brahman. The word Brahman means Brahat, which is called infinity. The beginningless and beginningless endless is called Brahman. Okay, so what I am experiencing is Brahman, the infinite, the God. Right? Is there end to this galaxy, stars, planets, millions and billions of them is what I am experiencing, God. But at the same time, I am feeling a small being. So now let me ask you, let me take you through a meditation, okay? To give you, to understand what progressive path is, two paths, the progressive path and direct path. Just, to give you an example, okay? Close your eyes. I'll just tell, take the first, first how the progressive path approaches me. Oh Lord, you are all powerful, you are almighty, you are infinite, beginningless, endless. I surrender myself to you. I surrender my all my actions at your feet. I surrender my mind to you. I surrender my intellect to you. Take me into your arms. Merge me with you. O Lord, you are my refuge. Save me. I want to become one with you. I am your servant. I am your child. Take me into your arms like a mother. Protect me. Save me. Give me jnana, give me bhakti, give me vairagya, give me wisdom, give me devotion, give me detachment. Make me one with you. I am like a child. I don't know the path. Guide me. Oh, kindly light. Save me. Show me the path. Show me the light. Hold my hand. Fill me with love. Fill me with the divine energy. Make my mind stay at your feet all the time. Whatever I see, let it become your sight. Whatever I hear may become your voice. Whatever I touch may be your feet. Show me the way. Show me the path. Take me into your arms. Asatoma. Sadgamaya,
Sadgamaya,
Tamasoma,
Tamasoma,
Jyotirgamaya,
Jyotirgamaya,
Mrityorma,
Mrityorma,
Amritamgamaya. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Lokah Samastah. Sukhino
bhavantu,
lokah samastah,
sukhino
bhavantu, lokah samastah, sukhino bhavantu. Hari Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Slowly open your eyes. Now the path of, this is actually progressive path or karma marga. So we can, through jnana, we can, through action, through devotion, through energy, we can do surrender to ourselves, to all. There's another path. The Lord is in myself. I am not there. My consciousness is Lord. Consciousness, Atma. I am nobody. I am nothing. The Chaitanyam or consciousness is myself. So let us do it inner journey. This is called direct path. Close your eyes. Become aware of the infinite universe, the beginningless, endless space, the vast space, millions and billions of stars and planets and galaxies are floating in that space. The huge space is called Bhutakasha or physical space. Where is that physical space? That physical space is in my mind. The mental space. The mental space is called Chittakasha. The infinite universe is in my mental space called Chittakasha. So where is my mind? The mind is in my consciousness, Chidakasha. There are three spaces, outer space called physical space, Bhutakasha. The mental space is called Chittakasha. And the space of consciousness is called Chidakasha. Become aware of your inner space from head to toe. The infinite physical space is mental concept in you. Take your attention to the heart center. Stay there. If any thought comes, become aware of yourself, who is watching the mind, Chidakasha. I am the witness of the mind, witness of the body, and witness of the universe. I am consciousness. I am the infinite being. In me, the mental space and consciousness space, physical space is there. Satoma Sagamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritamgamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Hari Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. So I just gave a small, in a short way, what is progressive path and what is direct path, just to make you understand. So there is a progressive path here, where there are steps. It is called Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Kriya Yoga. In direct path, you understand what is there happening and go directly to consciousness. So, this is what we are speaking about. If you look at one way, this is the progressive path, individual merging with the universal. individual merging with the universal. Universal is important, individual is merging with that. It's called bhakti, devotion, bhava. Whereas in the direct path, the universe is the individual. The consciousness is the individual, manifesting as individual. So you go inwards directly. First is individual in the universe. Second is universe in the individual. So it's like this. A seed of a mango tree becomes a tree. Whatever is there in the tree is in the seed. Similarly, the infinite universe is in you, because you are the seed. So this is progressive path. It's called Pindanda and Brahmanda. So in this path, progressive path, the Pindanda or individual merges with the Brahmanda, which involves steps, because it's a lot of steps. I have to understand, okay, which lokas are there, what God I have to worship, and how I reach them, because there are steps. In the individual path, the whole universe is in me. I have to just go inwards and find it. This is called direct path.
So something like the extroversion and introversion.
No, the extroversion and introversion word has come from psychology. We are not speaking of psychology. We are speaking of a different approach.
So in the progressive path, there is still a separation.
Yeah. So progressive path, what will happen? You go, there is a separation. I am separate from God. Oh, God, save me. So, but still, there's a gap. Finally, in the progressive path, we'll have to take a jump here. Direct path. But that doesn't mean that I'm telling direct path is superior. Okay? So, that's how normally happens. Yes, ma'am.
I remember, sir, the Ganesha and Subramanian.
Yeah. So, this path doesn't mean that this path is inferior or superior. There are two paths. You come to a level here where you are coming very close to God, then you have to take a jump to see the divine inside. So that's why Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa asked a question. What are the different types of devotees? Okay? Different types of bhaktas, devotees. So Ramakrishna Paramahamsa said, first level of bhakta says, oh God, save me. You are there, I am here. The next level bhakta says, God is in my heart. That's the next level of progression. The third level of realization is, God is everywhere. So now this is not a concept, okay? There's not a buzzword, God is everywhere. It has to be direct understanding, experience. So God is everywhere is the third level. So you are there, I am here. That's the first level. You are in my heart is next level. I am not there, you only are there everywhere. That's called Advaita. It's not that I am God. The God alone is there. It's called Advaita. Awesome.